just feel His holy presence when there's Southern gospel music all around. Don't you just love that gospel music? Don't you just love that Southern sound? Can't you just feel His holy presence when there's Southern gospel music all around? When there's Southern gospel music all
Welcome to Southern Style Praise. We're having a great day in studio today. Just glad y'all are here to join us. Just hope you get something out of the program. We just open up your heart and let Jesus come in and just hear the words that God has led the Joy Hours to share with you today. We are just so glad to have you all with us today. I don't think I'm supposed to reach in front, but it looks funny reaching behind. I'll figure this out one of these days, viewers. We've just had what we're doing today. We're not only doing a Southern Style Praise, but we're doing a video for the Joy Hours also. And so you're not going to get to see everything that they've done, but on screen we'll put their website. So if you want to get the whole DVD, you can just contact them and get it worked out. I think you'll really enjoy it. Ernie, if you will, introduce the group, and then just tell us a little bit about what God is doing with the group and with y'all's ministry.
Well, the young lady on the end, her name is Anna Brooks. She sang with us first back in 1996 and had some vocal problems and had to leave. But she's been back with us now 4 years, going on five. And she just, she likes me to tell this, she just became a grandma. But the worst part is she became a mother-in-law twice last year, and then
oh, no.
And then
oh, no.
she's a brand new grandma. She does a tremendous job. We travel a little bit of everywhere, and the Lord has just been so good to us. And then this is my wife Debbie Peters. She and I live in Harriman, Tennessee. All three of us, we go to Batley Baptist Church out in Clinton, and we're very pleased to be going there. And the Lord is just so good to us. And as far as our ministry goes, we have been probably singing more in camp meeting, jubilee type services more this year than we ever have. And the Lord is just so good. And I don't know if you've ever been able to attend any of those or not, but folks, they are the real deal. I just love it. Folks come and folks get saved, they get their needs met, and we just shout it out most of the time.
That's great. That's great. And God is, he shows up at the oddest places, don't he?
Yes, sir, he does. He's always there, and he's willing, if we will only let him. You know, the Bible says that the table is spread, and we just need sometimes to draw up and eat. It's like I've heard this analogy used a lot. Preachers say, what if your wife fixed a good meal and you never did show up to eat? Wouldn't be long. She'd quit fixing them.
That's exactly right. That's right. So let's just sing some more, and I just appreciate you guys so much.
Dale, it's a joy to be here today. We appreciate you and what you're doing.
All right. Thanks.
I am the one.
a dry and dusty bottom, where he gently reminds me again.
Yet it's hard to understand. For you see, I was nothing, but he gave me everything. And of his fullness, I now have received.
Grace for grace, mercy for justice.
From God above reminds me I've done nothing to deserve the Savior's love. God forbid that I should glory in the deeds that I have done, for it's by His grace and grace alone
the victory has been won. Those flames I'll never feel. Oh.
walked in a snowland filled with sorrow, toiling neath the load of all of my sin, listening to the voice of the old accuser telling me what a sinner I've been. But then good news from an old-time preacher told how Jesus makes things right. Ever since that wonderful moment, I've been saved and traveling light. I'm traveling light on this heavenly journey, going to a place called Glory Land, setting my sights on the heavenly city, not looking back to Egypt's land. I'm taking my steps in a new direction, keeping that heavenly prize in sight. And I'm walking and talking with Jesus, and praise God, I'm traveling light.
They pray.
by the window on a cold and cloudy day. An old man does the best he can just to pass the time away. The hand of death has taken his wife of many years. Tears stream down his weathered face, looking at an empty chair. She was his loving sweetheart, a precious gift from God. They'd served the Lord so faithfully through all the miles they trod. He never thought he'd be alone, that she'd always be there. But now he sits and longs for home, looking at an empty chair.
God gives grace to fill an empty chair. When loved ones leave, he promised he'll be there.
Our Savior for the grace that filled an empty chair. One day up in heaven, a search was made for all. A sacrifice was needed because of man's great fall. The Son of God prepared to leave, to pay the price alone, and left his Father sitting there, looking at an empty throne. He came down to a manger, grew up to be a man, laid down his life on Calvary, according to God's plan. Satan thought that he was finished, that death had sealed his doom. But 3 days later, Satan sat looking at an empty tomb.
God gives grace to fill an empty chair.
Savior for the grace that filled an empty chair.
We'll meet again in heaven, in a place that he's prepared.
And thank our Savior for the grace that filled an empty chair.
Sometimes we all do, why good things come to others, yet they seem to pass by you. Why the more you try to serve him, the harder things seem to get. Well, I'm glad to say there's a brighter day, and we
it's a place of pure delight. No sickness, no sorrow, no crying. Everything will be alright.
For the first time I'll see Jesus even though we've already met.
And when my race is run, the best is yet to come,
and we
are not home yet.
Have you ever walked through a valley? Satan whispers, no one cares. When all hope is gone, child, you're not alone. I know, 'cause I've been there. That's when my Lord reminds me, 'cause sometimes
even though